As a disclaimer, I am not a professional gunsmith, nor am I an official spokesperson for Panzer Arms of Turkey. Also included in the warranty is the warranty exclusions, stating, also, this warranty is void if any unauthorized repair or alteration is performed on the firearm. Okay, with that out of the way, let's get on to the business of showing you how to disassemble, some tips on cleaning and maintenance on your shotgun, and the reassembly. Before you begin disassembly, ensure that your firearm is on safety. If you prefer to store your firearm with a magazine in it, you'll have to release the magazine first by activating the magazine release. So you just release the magazine. Then you're going to have to, in order to lock the bolt back to ensure that, look in the chamber, make sure that it's empty, is you're going to have to switch the trigger to fire. Then you can pull the bolt back and lock it back using the lock release switch. And then you can look at the chamber to ensure that the gun is empty. To begin removing the barrel, you'll have to remove the faux muzzle brake in order to make this clearance here to remove the handguard cap nut. So you just unscrew the faux muzzle brake. Then you can unscrew the cap nut. And then you can now remove the handguard. After you remove the faux muzzle brake, you'll see this rubber O-ring at the end of the barrel. You'll have to remove this in order to clean the shotgun. Now this will deteriorate over time due to the barrel getting hot as you fire the shotgun and from replacing and removing the faux muzzle brake. Now I did find some replacements for this at Lowe's in the plumbing department, and they're number 40 O-ring with a 3/4 inch outer diameter by 5/8 inch inner diameter by 1/16 inch thickness. And there were 10 in here, and these were the perfect fit. These were $2.34. One thing to note is that after you remove the cap nut and you're removing the handguard, the handguard cap may come off. That's okay. It just goes right back in there whenever you're reassembling your weapon. And this is where the operational rod goes through, and this is where the barrel goes through. To remove the barrel, first ensure that you lock the bolt back. And they're not describing what this lever is, so I'm going to call it the bolt stop. And when it is in this horizontal position, the stop is up, keeping the bolt from going forward in the bolt carrier group. And when it is in the vertical position, it comes down, and that will allow you, when you're ready, to smoothly remove the bolt carrier group when you're ready to remove the barrel. So this is very, very stiff when you first disassemble your weapon, and I'll show you what I did to get it to work so smoothly. So you move it into the vertical position and you release your bolt. Then you can remove your barrel nut, and you'll have to get it past the operational rod. Then what I do is I just position my hand over the barrel and my thumb on the operational rod, and I gently pull back on the bolt, and that will allow me to pull the barrel out. Now this may be difficult also to come out the first time you do it, so what you'll have to do is you may have to take the bolt and just hammer it out, and I'll show you how I got mine to operate so smoothly. So you just pull the barrel out. Release the bolt slightly to pull it the rest of the way out. This is the gas piston. You can remove it. And then what you need to do is take the bolt, grab the spring and the bolt carrier, and kind of gently move it back. And you can put your finger on the bolt, because it's now movable very easily. And you'll want to line up those notches right there to pull the charging handle out. So you grab it, and you can pull the charging handle right out. And once you do that, the bolt, the spring, and the carrier will come out. This is the bolt carrier group. This is the bolt. This is where the charging handle goes. Right in there. This is where it fits into. And what I did, guys, is while I had it torn apart, because this was so hard, I worked this in and out really, really good multiple times. I'll show you some other tips. This here is the bolt fixing tube. Just goes in like that. And then you can clean these out. Clean them real good while you have it disassembled. To separate the upper from the lower, you're going to have to get into the buttstock to remove the upper receiver retention bolt. Now the upper is the upper part here and the operational rod, and the lower is one piece, which is the lower, the hand grip, and the buttstock. And you get inside the buttstock by removing the Phillips head screw that attaches the butt pad using a Phillips screwdriver. And then you use a half inch socket with either a 10 inch 3/8 inch extension or a 12 inch, and you attach the socket onto the extension, and I'll show you the difference here. This is the 10 inch, and there definitely is room to remove the bolt. However, I'm going to use a 12 inch, and it does make it a lot easier to remove the bolt. You can see there you have a generous amount of room. And then once you get the bolt loose enough, you can remove the ratchet and just continue taking the bolt out by hand. And that is the upper retention bolt right here. And once you have that done, you can simply separate your upper from your lower. I really do recommend that you disassemble and clean the shotgun before you use it the first time. All of these components were not really lubricated. They had a light coating of, you know, some kind of grease. And I was talking to my friend Fly Low Level. You know, there was grease in here, and he was saying that sometimes these guns ship, there was grease in here, sometimes these guns ship, they're not really lubricated, they're more like got a light coating of some kind of mechanical grease or something to keep them from rusting while they're in shipment. So I'm thinking that that may be why some of us are having troubles with the first time that they're firing, because they're not really being cleaned out. They really do need to be cleaned. The barrel, inside the barrel, was really greasy. It wasn't really lubricated like oily. So I do recommend, once again, that you do disassemble the firearm and you do clean it prior to your first shooting. What I did to make the bolt stop function smoothly is I grabbed a rag and I just grabbed the bolt stop and I just worked it up and down. I actually put on Netflix and watched a comedy show because this took me a long, long time to get this to finally smooth out. I even put on a pair of rubber grip gardening gloves to grab the lever to help me, because the lever is going to really do a number on your finger and your thumb as you're trying to smooth it out. What I did to make the moving parts a little bit easier to manage and smoother is that this is the bolt carrier group with the bolt, and this is where the charging handle goes into in that notch. And on the carrier, this is where it goes, the notch and the bearing, they snap together. And I just worked this in and out real, real good while I had it disassembled. And this took me quite a while too. I just, you know, used the towel and a pair of rubber gardening gloves. And I also took, you know, one of these emery board files, and I just sanded on the side here. And I didn't do much. You know, it came with some manufacturing, you know, rough edges. You know, they were sharp. I just smoothed it out a little bit. I didn't want to do too much because I did want this to be, you know, secured real well. And what I did with the barrel is I took, you know, I just took one side of the file, and it looked like I wasn't even doing much. You know, I sanded up in here and I sanded all around. And you know, you can do this with some, you know, wet sandpaper if you like, but I have these around. These are like $1.39 for a pack of 10. You know, I just bought these at the dollar store or Dollar General. And also what I did is this notch here, I smoothed it out because it was, you know, real, real rough also. So I just kind of sanded the edges and made it nicer. This is what goes into the upper receiver when you're assembling your weapon. And this fits right in here. And because it was rough, it made it real, real difficult to snap it in. So you can see it's still a little bit hard. So what I did is I took, you know, took the emery board. You know, I don't recall, but I may have even sanded in here just a little bit. You know, I just took one of the emery boards and I just kind of folded it. And I didn't do much in here. And I didn't do much in here. I mean, it didn't take me much at all. I, you know, went slowly. I think I used a total of 5 emery boards to do everything, but that really did help in making things a little bit easier to reassemble and disassemble the shotgun. To clean your shotgun, you can certainly use the items that came shipped with the shotgun. However, I do prefer a one-piece rod. That way I don't have to put a rod together. I use gun scrubber synthetic firearm cleaner, since everything is polymer, and that way I'm not going to damage any of the polymer components. I use a small brush to scrub everything down, and then I use Hoppe's gun bore cleaner to clean the barrel using the cotton patches. And I use Hoppe's lubricating oil to lubricate any moving components, and then I use a cloth to wipe everything down after reassembly to get the gun nice and clean. Always remember to clean your firearms in an open, well-ventilated area. Always use gloves to protect your hands from cleaning solvents. Using gun scrubber cleaner, spray all the parts with a generous amount of cleaner. Use a scrub brush to clean the bolt. Spray gun scrubber into the barrel and spray the upper and lower. Clean the barrel with the bore brush. Using a shotgun patch holder and shotgun cotton patches, dip the patches into Hoppe's bore cleaner and clean the barrel. You'll need to do this 3 to 4 times to thoroughly clean the barrel. Check the barrel to make sure it's clean. Lightly soak a couple of cotton patches with some lubricating oil and lubricate the barrel. And while I had it disassembled for the first time, I also lubricated the trigger safety, the magazine release, and the bolt stop. This helped to make these operate much more smoothly. And I also added a few drops of oil to the bolt carrier channel on the inside of the upper and just spread it around the inside with my fingers. Then, using the oil that was on my hands, I oiled the rest of the parts. And finally, I used a cloth to wipe off any excess oil. All right, now that you're ready for reassembly, you'll have to put the upper and lower together, and then you'll have to close it up by replacing the butt pad. And I just put the upper receiver retention bolt on first. Go ahead and feed it through. Line it up. And get it started. Now you're ready to reassemble the bolt carrier group in the barrel. So what you'll want to do first is make sure that your bolt stop is in the vertical position so that the bolt stop is down so that you can easily reinsert the bolt carrier group in the barrel. So you will just replace the bolt fixing tube and the bolt. Insert the operational spring, and then you'll want to insert the operational tube into the spring and the bolt fixing tube, and insert the bolt into the upper. And then what you're going to want to do is line up those notches again so that you can insert your charging handle. And then go ahead and leave it like that. Now, go ahead and put your gas piston into the barrel. And then go ahead, and what you're going to want to do is make sure that the bolt is up front with the upper. Insert the operational tube into the gas piston, and then line up those notches. And then insert the barrel and shove it in. Then you can replace your barrel nut. And now you're ready to replace the handguard and the full muzzle brake. Before you complete the reassembly, make sure that you put the O-ring back onto the front of the barrel. And what you'll want to do first is put on the handguard. Replace the end cap. Replace the cap nut. And then replace the full muzzle brake. Then you can take your bolt, pull the handle back, place the bolt stop in the horizontal position so that the bolt stop is up, and you're done.